All right, gonna do a video just on Brian Dellinger, and I had to do this because I was going back and forth with one of Brian's followers in the comments of Tim's video, and Brian left a comment on Tim's recent video, Brother Tim Condon, and it just reminded me how much Brian lies and just how much Brian Dellinger is an unrepentant liar and how prideful and arrogant he is, and just how prideful and arrogant his followers are too. People don't like it when you call out their cult leader. People don't like it when you call out their pope, the guy they just emulate and worship. And this one Brian Dellinger follower is going back and forth, and he flat out calls me a devil because he said I was attacking Brian, even though I told him that I got rid of the videos I did attacking Brian, and gonna get into more of that in the future of this video. But basically, Brian Dellinger is an unrepentant liar. And back in July of 2020, or June of 2020, Tim came out with three videos. One responding to JT and how Brian Dellinger and JT were covering up a sinful interracial marriage attempt. They were covering up the sin of interracial marriage. And Tim came out with two videos admonishing Brian. And Tim just showed how Brian lied over and over and over again. I mean, Brian was just caught in so many lies, blatant hypocrisy. I mean, pride was just oozing out of Brian in the emails back to Tim. And Brian comes up with the video, and he doesn't deal with the whole video. Brian does not deal with the whole video Tim made. Brian just took a little clip out of context and just hung on that and completely detracted from the point of the video because he's a liar. He's an unrepentant liar. And his pride got hurt. Tim hurt Brian's pride. And let me just say this, I do believe Brian is a saved man. Okay, I'm not saying he's unsaved. I'm just saying he's got some very, very serious pride issues. Very, very high-minded, very arrogant, very prideful. And he needs to repent of that. I don't care how old he is. I don't care if he's an elder or not. He needs to repent of that. Okay, just because you're an elder does not shield you from being rebuked. And that's another thing too. Cult leaders will often use their status as a preacher to deflect criticism and say, "Oh, don't criticize me. Don't talk down to me. I'm the preacher."
Right. I got to say something else here before you go back to the video. I never, as a teenager, would have thought about talking this way about a preacher, you know?
He has to dial back the inner person because he can't be honest about what he really feels. And what he'd really like to say about me, a preacher.
That's slander. You're lying about a preacher.
And Tim showed that in his video. Tim showed how Brian Dellinger was using his age and saying, "I'm older than you, Tim." He showed how Brian was saying, "Where's your respect for a preacher? You've learned so much from me. I've taught you so much." I mean, just pride, 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 just oozing out of Brian. He's got very serious pride issues. And because Tim exposed that, Tim showed that Brian is in error, Brian was the one who's wrong, and then Brian has completely another one of the big lies Brian told that he hasn't repented of so far is that, oh, you know, Tim just got offended, Tim just, you know, his feelings got hurt, he got offended, you know.
Let's show this one here. What's with all the backstabbing and craziness with a brother that I have seen on live chats with you a lot? He got offended.
And this one Brian Dellinger follower I was going back and forth with, he was accusing me of loving my sin because I spoke against Brian Dellinger. That's another common lie. Brian had to lie about why Tim came up with those two videos admonishing him because Brian was calling people lost based on sins of the flesh.
And if you're not convicted at all by this, see, there's two types of sinners, okay? There's the one that's struggling with sin, and there's the one that defends it. Get a hold of that one. The two types of sinners, struggling sinners and ones that defend it. Saved people struggle with sin. I get that. I understand that. But when you start to defend it and start to say, "Well, there's nothing wrong with it. The Holy Spirit doesn't convict me." That's because you don't have the Holy Spirit. You're lost.
Okay, that's why I criticized Brian because he was calling people lost. I have no problem with preaching hard against sin. Okay, contrary to what Brian's followers will lie about me, and quite frankly, I just block them. Any Dellinger followers comment on this video, you're blocked. I have no time for you. If you're going to come here and defend your cult leader and not actually deal with the facts and deal with the scriptures and that kind of stuff, you're blocked. I don't care. I don't have time to deal with you. Proverbs 18:13 says, "He that answereth the matter before he heareth it, it is folly and shame unto him." And many of Brian's followers are in folly and shame. They answered the matter before they heard it. So anyway, Brian came up with a video totally lying and saying, "Oh, he just got offended," and that kind of stuff. Even though Tim made it very clear over and over again in his video that the issue was not about preaching hard against sin, the issue was Brian calling people lost based on sins of the flesh. Tim correctly pointed out that calling people lost over sin is exactly why Brian is accused of preaching lordship salvation, backloading works, being legalistic and pharisaical. Because judging salvation based off sin is what a lordship salvation person will do. So Tim was right, and Brian had to completely flip and make it out, oh, he got offended over me preaching hard against sin. Total lie, and Tim made it clear that was not the case, but Brian did not show Tim's whole video, and he just lied. Another example of Brian's lies is he said that, oh, Tim is joining the ranks of the Fenningerites and all the other wicked heretics.
And he's now joining the ranks of Pale Eddie and all the others that were former Denlinger watchers, and now they just spend all their time making video after video after video exposing me.
Who just attack Brian on a regular basis. And again, it's a blatant lie. If Brian's followers actually bother to watch the video and not be a respecter of persons towards Brian and not answer the matter before they hear it, they would actually see that Tim made it very clear that he was not joining up with the Fenningerites. He was not joining up with Ed Fenninger, King's Table, and all the other wicked heretics who just have all these weird heresies. Romans 10 is not for the Gentiles, and, you know, dispensation, there's salvation by faith in every dispensation. Yeah, all wicked heresy. And then people like me who also leave, I also get lumped in with those heretics as well. So they have this cultic mentality of, if you're not with us, you must be with this people. You know, it's Roman Catholic. They behave like Roman Catholics. And that's why, you know, Brian got offended. Oh, they're calling me Father Brian. Yeah, because you behave like a Catholic priest. People are calling you Father Brian because how you deal with people who disagree with you is exactly how a Catholic priest would. You call them lost. You say, oh, you're probably not saved, or you have your followers come on and send them your salvation message. You are so much like a Catholic priest, it's crazy. That's why people call you Father Brian. Okay? Brian, you're called a pope because you behave like a pope. You're called a father because you behave like a Catholic priest. That's just how it goes. It's funny how the Denlinger cult is just so anti-Catholic, yet they're actually behaving like Catholics themselves. They're becoming the very Catholic cult they hate. Okay, and Roman Catholicism is a cult. And it's sad how similar the Denlinger cult is to the Roman Catholic cult. Denlinger preaches a lot of truth, okay? Denlinger has spoken a lot of truth. He knows the Bible very well. I've learned a lot from him. But that doesn't change the fact that he needs to be corrected and reproved. And just because you're an elder does not mean you can't be rebuked or reproved, okay? 1 Timothy chapter 5, verses 18 to 20 lay out the qualifications for rebuking an elder. You have to have at least two or three witnesses, okay? When the Bible says, because they'll rip 1 Timothy 5:1 totally out of context, when it says rebuke not an elder, well, read the rest of the verse. Read down to verses 18 through 20. I believe it's 18 through 20. It says, you know, against an elder receive not an accusation, but before two or three witnesses. So if you have two or three witnesses, you have every right to rebuke the elder. He's not above receiving correction. And Brian seems to think that being an elder means he's above correction. It's wicked. It's Catholic. This thing of, oh, this he has a papal infallibility type mentality. So anyway, back to the lies of Brian Denlinger that so far he hasn't repented of yet. He said that Tim was joining the ranks defending Earth. That was a lie. And there was a bunch of other stuff too. And when someone, Tim showed in the video, when someone left a comment on Brian's video saying, wait a second, how come you didn't show the whole video? And it was a light rebuke to Brian Denlinger. Philip Newton, this clone of Brian Denlinger, he literally looks like a clone of Brian Denlinger. He sends the guy Brian's salvation message and calls him lost. So according to the Denlinger cult, if you disagree with Brian Denlinger, if you speak against Brian Denlinger, you're lost. I had one of them call me a devil just because I was speaking against Brian Denlinger. I mean, that's wicked. That's cultic. Very, very cultic. They call someone lost based on just speaking against your leader. And again, like I said at the beginning, cultists, cult members don't like it when you call out their cult leader for heresy. They don't like it. They can't stand it. Okay? And this kind of behavior is exactly why Brian is called a cult leader by heretics like Ed Fenninger and King's Table and Max Bauer, etc. Exactly why. There's a reason why Brian's accused of these type of things. There's a reason why Brian's accused of being lazy or being money hungry. Because he has, sorry, just, lights back on, here we go. Because he has like so many different properties, and it's like people are accusing him of these things for a reason, okay? Why does a preacher need like two different properties, and like both of them are like pretty big properties as well? You know, all on your donation money, okay? I mean, plus, where in the Bible do you just sit around and just ask for donations, okay? I actually work, I have a job. I work during the week. I work really hard with what I do. My job is very physically demanding. Okay, I earn my wages properly. Okay, even Paul, you can read in Acts chapter 18, Paul was a tent maker. Paul didn't just sit around and just beg for donations. You know, Jesus Christ was a carpenter. Even Jesus Christ, the Son of God, he didn't sit around and just beg for money. It's wicked. So Brian, and I think the whole reason too, the reason why Brian has to come out and lie and just openly just be dishonest. It's because, you know, if people saw Brian Dillinger for what he truly is, a liar and a hypocrite, and an unrepentant liar and hypocrite, and just filled with pride, they would stop donating to him. So his money, would, his finances would go down and down and down. Again, I'm being harsh because, yes, Brian Dillinger is a brother in Christ. However, he needs to be rebuked sharply. And this is a harsh rebuke against Brian Dillinger. He needs to be rebuked. He's got very, very serious pride issues, very high-minded, very arrogant, very self-righteous. He needs to be rebuked sharply. And I don't care if he's a lot older than me. Remember, 1 Timothy chapter 5 does lay out qualifications for rebuking an elder before two or three witnesses. You know, paraphrasing, of course. But there are plenty of witnesses that I would have that back me up of Brian Dillinger's blatant wickedness, pride, and hypocrisy. So I have every right to rebuke Brian Dillinger, and he can't say, oh, I'm an elder. And again, this thing of, oh, I'm an elder, you can't speak against me, that's the same mentality the IFB used to have. Brian Dillinger would condemn the IFB for having this don't speak against a man of God mentality. Now Brian has the exact same mentality. If he's an elder, you can't speak against him. You can't talk down to him. He's an elder. Cultic. That's what all cult leaders do. So back to the lies against Tim. He also, of course, said that Tim got offended, which was not true. And he plays a little bit of the video. Doesn't deal with Tim's whole video. He just plays a little tiny little excerpt, which he complains that the enemies, like Ed Fenninger and those guys, take him out of context, yet he does the exact same thing back to Tim. What a hypocrite. Total hypocrite. And that's not the only example of Brian Dillinger's blatant hypocrisy. Okay? And yeah, I'm letting him have it, because he needs to be rebuked. Okay? He may be an elder, but that does not shield him from being rebuked, okay? Just because you're older doesn't mean squat when you're wrong and you're in error and you're in sin, unrepentant sin. So he lied about Tim. He also, his followers lying about Tim, and never bothered to watch Tim's video. They just looked at Brian's video and they just said, oh, you know, whatever Brian says must be true. They're respecters of persons towards Brian. That simple. It's a cult of personality. Some of Brian's followers even start dressing like Brian and looking like Brian. It's a cult of personality. Just that simple. That's why... stupid light keeps going off. That's why I broke fellowship with Brian. And when I did break fellowship with Brian, I had people calling me lost as well. I had people saying I'm lost and I'm a devil for speaking against Brian. It's wicked. I mean, how is this any different? Again, how is this any different than the Roman Catholic Church? Okay? The Roman Catholic Church will call you lost if you speak against the Holy Mother Church. They're doing the same thing. Again, they're becoming the very cult they hate. They're becoming the very Catholic, Roman Catholic harlot cult they hate. You know, the One World Harlot Church, the Roman Catholic Church, they're becoming just like Roman Catholics. That simple. So, all that to say this is that Brian Dillinger is needs to repent of his pride, okay? And in the, and back to the comments on the video, Tim did a video talking about the news, and Brian left a comment again openly lying about Tim, saying, oh, you know, you said you shouldn't talk about the news when you're in ministry. When did Tim ever say that? You know, Brian did not provide an example. He just accused Tim of saying that. A blatant lie. Again, Brian is an unrepentant liar. Okay? He just lies to get his opinions forth. He just lies to get his agenda across. He has no conviction. That's why I say he may be an elder, but he's behaving like a little child. Okay? He does not deserve the title of an elder by the way he's behaving right now. Okay? Brian, may the Lord Jesus Christ rebuke you. May he rebuke you sharply, because you've got some very, very serious pride issues. You're very high-minded. You're very arrogant. You're very self-righteous. You have a big ego. You need to repent. And let me just say this. Stupid lights, it just goes off every once in a while. If you don't repent, Brian, I pray the Lord Jesus Christ gives a severe, severe chastening upon you and your household. Severe chastening. And I pray the chastening stays there until you repent of your pride and your arrogance and your high-mindedness and your hypocrisy too. And your blatant lying. May the Lord Jesus Christ rebuke you, Brian. And may the Lord Jesus Christ rebuke all of Brian's followers that will get on this video and call me lost for speaking against their cult leader, their pope. Okay, again, any of Dillinger's followers get on this video and just call me lost and, you know, oh, you're speaking against a man of God, you're blocked. I have no time for you, okay? If you're not going to deal with the facts, if you're not going to take the rebuke, if you just think that Brian Dillinger is above receiving reproof, you're blocked. I have no time for you. I have better things to do. I have work to do. I actually have a job I have to focus on. I actually have, you know, studying the Bible, reading the Bible, studying the Word of God, you know, learning Scripture, producing videos for the channel. I have better things to do than deal with the cultic Dillingerites who just are going to call me lost for speaking against your Pope. So, again, may the Lord Jesus Christ rebuke you, Brian, and may the Lord Jesus Christ rebuke all of Brian's followers who just falsely accuse people and rail against people who just dare to question something Brian Denlinger says. And again, any of them comment, they're going to be blocked. I have no time for them. I already have several of them blocked right now, actually, because they're just causing problems. It's ridiculous. So anyway, pray for Brother Tim. Pray for his ministry. Pray for his, I just say pray for God's blessing on him. Tim did a big thing speaking against Brian, because Brian is intimidating. People are afraid to speak against Brian. So Tim was very bold and he spoke against the cult leader. And what do you know? The cult leader didn't like it and he got all offended because his pride got hurt. Okay, so don't. And I'll just say this as this again: Brian Denlinger, I do believe is a saved man, but based on the way he's behaving, I can only say this: that King James Video Ministries started off. It started off very good, started off very godly, very wholesome, but it sadly has turned into a Brian Denlinger cult. Sorry, I just had a phone call right there. Someone tried to call me. It sadly has turned into a Brian Denlinger cult, a Brian Denlinger cult of personality. So my only recommendation is, while Brian Denlinger has put out a lot of good truth, the way he's behaving right now. Sorry, I had a phone call trying to get back to me. The way he's behaving right now, the only option left is to just simply mark and avoid Brian Dillinger like the plague. That's the only option left. Based on how he's behaving, mark and avoid him like the plague. Okay? Pray for. Oh. Sorry that this person keeps trying to call me. It's so annoying. But mark and avoid Brian Dillinger. Don't be deceived by this cult. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all the brethren. Goodbye.